So we just chilling here in traffic. Thought I'd make a video. What's going on, y'all? It's your boy Avery, and I want to get a few things out of the way in this video. Number one, the Droll and Lockbird, all that controversy stuff. So for this video, basically, I want to talk about my Trickstar deck profile, because I topped and all that. Also, to the people saying it's not actually a top, I consider it a top. Do with that what you will. Also, I wanted to apologize to my previous video for the audio being really bad. I don't know what happened. Yeah, just my audio fucked up. So I'm sorry. I don't know what happened. So, the Droll and Lockbird and the Trickstar deck and all that. God, my nose is fucking itchy. Someone left a comment saying that the judge at their locals said that you cannot activate reincarnation and chain Droll and Lockbird. To you, my friend, your judge is a fucking idiot. When a regional judge and when every other judge under the fucking sun will tell you that that's how it works, they are a fucking idiot, and or they just don't want to see your deck do well. This actually happened to me at Phoenix Games in Orlando, Florida, long ass time ago. Like, we're talking maybe, I want to say like 5 years ago. We were still like had Exceed Monsters and all that. We didn't have no Pendulum, none of that. This is like maybe 5 years ago. And actually, no, maybe seven. I think this is back in like 2010, 2011. And the judge that was there tried to say that my dad, he was playing Chamber. He tried to say that my dad couldn't chain accumulated to accumulated, which he was the biggest fucking moron in the entire planet. Like, if you don't know that ruling, I understand if you're new at the game and you don't know that ruling, that's okay. But when you're an experienced player, which you are if you're a judge at your local game store, usually, then you're just a fucking idiot and you don't want to see Chamber do well. So my dad had already beat somebody. My dad ended up scooping the match. He said, well, I'm not going to play then. I'm not going to do this because then I can't play my deck properly. So he ended up dropping out of the tournament. I didn't blame him. The dude was a fucking dickhead, and I still see him at events to this day, and he scrubs out like a little bitch. Like, it's just how it is. It's just how the game is. To clarify how it works, because I know I said that you would do reincarnation. There are other ways to doing it. The deck profile was almost 20 minutes long. I had to kind of cut some things out. So, at the regional, one of the things that I did was I had a Droll and Lockbird. I set reincarnation, told my opponent to pass. I search it off of Candina. He draws. He goes diagram. I go sure. He goes effect. Pop a card in my hand. Search. I go, okay, that's fine. At resolution, reincarnation, response, no response. Chain, Droll, and Lockbird. Resolves, your shit goes away. You're left with a diagram and like an overraptor in your graveyard. Come at me, bro. So, of course, he ended up past turn. He couldn't do shit. And yeah, it was funny. That's one way of doing the combo. The other way, as I explained in the comment section, you have two reincarnations, you pass turn, opponent draws, you activate reincarnation during their standby phase, it resolves, they banish six, draw six, they enter main phase one, when they enter main phase one, you activate the second reincarnation, chain Droll and Lockbird, they lose their hand. So, I know a lot of people were questioning me and telling me there are other ways to do the reincarnation combo. Yes, I'm aware that there are other ways to do the combo. So, yeah, again, I know I already brought this up, but I want to also apologize again for the audio. Once I upload this video, by the time you see this video, that video is going to be deleted. I just want to make an update video talking to you guys about how uploads are going to be very infrequent because I am back in school. I'm at a four-year university now, and I have 2 years left of college, and traffic sucks dick. So uploads are going to be somewhat infrequent just because of the fact that, you know, I'm kind of in the big leagues now classwork-wise. You know, I really have to step my game up and keep up with my stuff and make sure that I have, you know, everything right and, you know, dot my I's and cross my T's and all that fun stuff. Girls are fucking hot in college, man. I'm not gonna lie. Like, for those of you who live in America and you're aware of, like, the big name colleges and stuff, like, for example, the University of Florida or Florida State University. Well, I'm at the University of North Florida, which is nowhere near as big as the University of Florida, for those of you who like college football and all that. But it's a four-year college nonetheless, and hot damn, this motherfucker's trying to cut me off, you piece of shit. Yeah, he has a challenger too. Well, get over, you fucking cock. Sorry, I have terrible road rage. If y'all want to see a road rage video, let me know in the comments below, because two cuckheads just fucking cut me off. Anyway, so that was a nice GT. You can probably, may have heard that engine. There you go. All engine, no bite. It's not as fast as a Challenger. Anyway, so the girls are fine as hell at a university. I'm just saying. If you're a girl and you watch my videos, which is surprising as all get out, then you know what I'm talking about. Which, I was looking at my analytics a couple weeks ago. No, maybe a couple months ago. I saw that 95, nice try, motherfucker. 95% of my audience is male and 5% is female. I saw that shit. I was like, what 5% of women are watching my videos? I mean, I don't know if YouTube's analytics are like on the dot perfect, but holy hell, 5% of our women who watch my videos. And I mean, I know that there's not a lot of Yu-Gi-Oh players that are female, but it just still blew me away, like 5%. Like, that blows me away as, you know, the Yu-Gi-Oh community in general. Like, that just goes to show that the game is growing, even though I only have 5%. You know, other channels might have 40% or 50%, you know? It's nice to see that the game is growing and that it's appealing to, you know, all genders and all, you know, ages and all that fun stuff. So, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and sit in traffic. If y'all enjoyed this little short update video, please be sure to leave a like. I'm going to try and post as much as I can, but I just wanted to kind of talk with you guys, see what was going on. I really appreciate all the support you guys have been giving me. Thank you to all the new subscribers I gained from topping that event. I'm probably still going to play Trickstars. I mean, really, it's the only deck I can play right now next to Statue, Sun, and Chamber, and both those decks are garbage anyway. I actually saw a guy at the regional. I don't know if I mentioned my deck profile or not. He was playing Chamber, and I think he scrubbed out because I didn't see him top. Which just goes to show that just because Chamber won Dragon Duels doesn't mean the deck's good. The deck is still garbage and trash. And shout out to my boy Derek saying Pod of Desires is good in Chamber. No, Derek. Pod of Desires is fucking trash. You play Pod of Desires in Chamber and you tell me how fucking good it goes for you, because that shit is trash. I don't want to banish the top 10 cards in my deck, which could all be burn and stall cards just to potentially draw two good cards. Big Daddy don't play like that. Anyway, thank you guys for watching as always. I'm going to sit here in traffic. That's a nice-ass green Mustang next to me. And subscribe if you have not already.